Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I am Jad, and today we're going to learn how to model the stairs procedurally in 3ds Max. You will have the ability to change all its parameters without breaking the model. Let's start by creating a plane. I will set it to 30 by 120 centimeters as a starting point. Set the length and width segments to 1 and rename it to stairs. Now we will start by adding attribute holder modifier. This modifier will stay on top and will help us access all our attributes easily without searching through the modifiers later on. Now press J on the keyboard and open the dope sheet. You will need to press on this button over here to show all the objects in the scene. Expand the stairs, open modified object and expand plane. Now right click on the length and choose publish parameters. Then we have to select our object and choose top space modifier. This will publish the selected parameter to the attribute holder for an easier access later on. We want to publish the width parameter as well, just follow the same steps as before. I like to keep everything properly named from the start, so go to animation and open the parameter editor. Here you can add and edit the parameters. We want to edit the parameters we published. Make sure to select the attribute holder modifier and click on edit. Then select length, which is responsible for the step's depth, so I'll rename it to depth, and click on apply. Width is alright, let's leave it as it is. Now we want to create the second flight of the stairs. I want to make it procedurally, so we can add an array modifier and make two copies on the x-axis. We can center the array as well, and I want to have control over the spacing in order to be able to change the gap in the middle. Navigate through the dope sheet for spacing x inside the array. Right click on it and publish it. Same as earlier, let's stay organized and rename it to gap and apply the changes. Next, let's start adding the actual steps. We can do that by applying a second array modifier on top. Remove all the copies on the x-axis and add some copies on the y-axis. In order to create the riser height, change the position mode to incremental and set the z value to something around 15 centimeters. Let's go back to the dope sheet and publish the array count y parameter. We also need to publish the z value in order to be able to control the riser height as well. Rename the parameters we've exported. Don't forget to select the attribute holder before you click on edit. I'll change count y name to steps count and change position Z to steps height. Next, we want to set the stairs overall height. Go to the first array and change the position mode to alternating, since the first array is actually creating the last steps in the stairs. In order to make it procedural, we need to calculate the overall height of the stairs and place it in the Z position. In order to do that, right-click on Z and assign a controller to it. Choose Float Expression and click OK. A new menu will pop up where we can dial in the expression we want. First, we need to create a variable. Call it CT for steps count and press on Create. Then, we need to assign it to a controller. Expand Objects, Stairs, Modified Object, attribute holder, then custom attributes, and choose steps count and press OK. Now write in the expression the value CT and hit evaluate, then press on debug in order to view the value we're getting. You can see that the value is 10 because the steps count is currently set to 10. In order to get the stairs overall height, we need to multiply this value with the single step height. So let's create another variable. Let's name it H, then assign it to the steps height controller, same as before. Next, write count multiplied by height in the expression value and press on evaluate. You can see that the Z value became 150 cm, which is half the overall height. That's because the steps count is actually for one flight only, while we are making a U-shaped stairs, which has two flights in it. So in order to get the overall height, we need to multiply the expression by 2. Now the value is 300 cm, which is exactly what we need. For our next step, let's add the connection between the steps. We will do that by adding an edit poly modifier between the two array modifiers. Go to edge level and select these two edges and bridge them together. Then exit the edit poly. Since we will not change any topology before the edit poly modifier, the model will not break, so we can change the gap or any value procedurally. Next, we need to invert the direction of the second flight. To do so, we will need some extra data from the second array modifier. To get this data, navigate to UV rollout and set it to clone XYZ. Let's disable the additive option, since we only need this information separately, and let's save it to the channel 2. Now, in order to use this information, let's add a data channel modifier. Press on add operator to open the list of operators we can work with, and let's start by adding a vertex input operator. Change the input to map channel 2, enable display, and switch it to Y since the array clones are on the Y axis. Let's enable show numeric in order to view the actual values we have in the model. We can see that the steps have a value spreading from 0 to 1 towards the Y axis. Now we need to isolate the top part of the stairs since we only need to invert the second flight. So basically, we need this bottom portion to have a value of 0. In order to do that, we will need a second data channel modifier before the second array. I will rename it to something like DC isolate top to keep the stack easy to read. Now let's start by adding a component space operator. This operator will return values between 0 to 1 for each vertex on the selected axis. We want to isolate the top part, so let's switch it to Z axis. If we show the numeric values, we can see that the bottom vertices have a value of 0 and the top part have a value of 1, which is exactly what we need. Now, let's add a vertex output, set it to map channel, and save it on channel 3. And on the Z, since we're isolating along the Z axis. Now let's go back to the first data channel and add another vertex input operator. Set it to map channel 3 and Z axis. You can see that all the bottom vertices now have a value of 0. If you change the mode to replace, you can see that we are just reusing the information we have in the other data channel. So let's multiply it to zero out the bottom vertices. Next, we want to scale these values to the overall height of the stairs. So add a scale operator. This basically multiplies the stack with a specific value. We want to multiply it by the overall height. So navigate to the first array and copy the controller of the Z position. And go back to the scale value and paste it as an instance. Now let's output this information. Use a vertex output and set it to output to the position on the Z axis. And we want to subtract this data. And now we have a two flight stairs. Of course, you can play around with the values in the attribute holder modifier to customize the stairs. I'll also rename the data channel modifier to something like DC set height to keep the stack organized. Now for the next step, we need to create the landing for the stairs. We will do that by using another data channel modifier. I will rename it to something like DC landing. Now let's start by adding a component space operator, enable display, change it to Y axis, and let's show the numeric values to get a better understanding of what the operator is doing. You can see that we have a values on the vertices spreading from 0 to 1 on the y-axis. We want to isolate the last vertices on the y-axis in order to be able to extend it procedurally. In order to do that, we will need a curve operator. Open the curve control and expand it a bit. This operator gives us the ability to remap our values according to this curve here. So in order to isolate the last part, first change the points type to corner, then add a new point on the curve and set its position to 0.99 and its value to 0. Now if we show the numeric values, you can see that we are setting all the values to 0 except the last vertices. After we isolated the landing edge, let's add a scale operator to control the depth of the landing. And since we want the ability to control this later, let's publish it in the dope sheet editor. We still need to output it, so let's add a vertex output operator set to output position on the y-axis and set the method to add, because we want to add this value to the original position in order to extend it. Now to stay organized, select the attribute holder and edit the name to landing. Next, let's add a chamfer modifier to bevel the edges. Don't forget to enable inset and use a small value to keep the smoothing on the beveled area only. Increase the segments to 3 and change the minimum angle to 1 to have the bevel at all times without chamfering the flat edges in the landing. I want to publish the chamfer amount in order to be able to change it later on without searching through the stack. So let's publish it in the dope sheet and change its name to bevel. We also need to add thickness to the stairs, so let's use the shell modifier. We don't need to use the outer amount, only the inner amount will do. Let's publish it as well and change its name to thickness. Now we have a fully procedural U-shaped stairs. We can change any value here without breaking the model. But we have a small issue if we set the gap to 0. To fix that, just add a vertex weld modifier before the chamfer. That will take care of this problem. You can play around the depth, width, the gap, steps count, step height, the landing, the bevel and the thickness of the stairs. One last thing I want to add is a small bevel to the edges. Add a second chamfer modifier after the shell, give it a small value, something like 0.5 centimeters, increase the segments a bit, enable inset and set it to flow loop, and give it a small amount as well. Now we have finished this fully parametric stairs. Please tell me in the comments section what do you think of this modeling method. If you want to learn how to create professional visualizations from start to finish, check out our training. You can also watch other tutorials here on YouTube. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.